Hello, I'm Justin Ross and I'm back and we're going to show you how to connect the ESA 612, 14, 15, same connection setup to a defibrillator one time. And we're gonna assume this time that our defibrillator is a 3-lead or 5-lead defibrillator. So in order to do that, we're gonna need a set of hands-free adapters. You'll get this from your Impulse 7000. So when you're done doing your discharge test, you'll take this out of the Impulse 7000 and we're simply going to connect these over here like this. All right, this is our applied parts. And then we'll need the help of these adapters. And these adapters, the part number on these is 246-2072. And what they are, here we go, I get three of them out. What they are is a snap to banana pin adapter. And those I'm then gonna put in these three ports, just like this. Here we go. And three. So what I would do here is I would hook our 3-lead ECG up right to these ports. So here's your 3-lead ECG and here's our hands-free adapter. All right, now moving forward, we're gonna plug our defibrillator into the safety analyzer, right into the outlet, boop. And then we're gonna have our ground wire. This is so awesome. This is so much better than the old Calvin cables. It's a single wire, so if you get across the hospital and forget a cable, lose a cable, eat the cable, break the cable, grab any of our cables. And we're simply gonna take it to the ground pin. We're gonna go to the ground wire resistance and we're going to zero it out. Now that that's done, we're gonna take this to the ground stud on the defibrillator. And that would give us our ground wire resistance. That simple. And we can go over here to leakage and we can do our ground wire leakage, normal polarity, single fault condition, easy enough. We can do our chassis leakage if you need it. We can do normal and we'll close the neutral. So that gives us normal condition. You can raise the earth for single fault. And if you do reverse, easy enough, reverse polarity, push the polarity button, take it to off and then reverse polarity for reverse polarity testing. But now let's move past this in the specific test and let's get to the applied parts test where we're gonna do this all this connection at one time. So we're gonna go to more. And you'll see that this black bar with these five dots corresponds to these five ports across the top. So if we go down to our arrow here, you have different selections about which ports are going to be bonded together and which ones are independent. So we can get to this one. So these first three studs where our ECG leads are connected are barred together. And then over here, the hands-free adapter is barred together. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. Now, close my earth. So I have normal polarity, normal condition, and I'm highlighted over here, so these three. So here's my leakage on these three leads. Simply hit the over arrow, and here's my leakage, normal polarity, normal condition for my hands-free adapter. Simple enough then, I'm gonna raise the earth, and I have single fault condition for my hands-free adapter. Over arrow, and I can have single fault condition for my three ECG leads. That simply leads isolation or sync current test, however you want to phrase it. We're gonna go to that button. And we're here on the three leads, so I'm not gonna touch that because I'm gonna push test. 120 volts is gonna come out of here through the ECG leads, back into the power port. There's our leakage. And once again, over, test, 120 volts out of the hands-free adapter port, back through the defibrillator. And in, and there's our results. Look at that, we connected the entire defib one time and we've done all the testing we need. It is a big time saver. So now the question is gonna be, well, my defibrillator has 5 leads or it's a 12 lead, what do I do? Check back in our next video and we'll show you how to do that. Thank you.